Hi, my name is Dave Cross and I build MIDI controllers. What's a MIDI controller? It's a device that controls music gadgets, things like samplers, sequencers, and synthesizers. But these days they're getting pretty popular as devices to control music and DJ software in computers. This is a MIDI controller. So is this. And this. In the next 5 minutes, I'm going to show you how I built this MIDI controller. It was designed to control something called a parametric equalizer inside of music software. But since it just speaks MIDI, it could control pretty much anything. It's just been expressly laid out for this purpose. Now to keep us all under 5 minutes, I'm going to skip some details, but I posted a website where I went into every little thing that went into this build. So you could use this video and the website to build this exact controller or a layout of your very own choosing. So let's start with an inventory of parts. This is a MIDI brain. These do all the hard work. These let people like you or me build MIDI controllers. If it weren't for MIDI brains, only large companies and engineers could pull this off. The MIDI brain I'm choosing for this project is called the UMC32+M by a company called Hale Microsystems. I've used their boards in the past and they work quite well. I'm putting the controller on a piece of plywood with an aluminum box. And finally, I've got a bunch of knobs, wire, and switches to make these connections. So, how does this all come together? This looks pretty intimidating, right? It's actually not that bad. First of all, we only care about these bits. This is where all the magic happens. We need to get knobs and switches to touch specific pins on them. How do they connect? Let's look at a knob. It has three connectors. Okay, now the pins. There's 10 of them. The three connectors need to touch these three pins. How do I know this? It's in the MIDI brain manual. So let's see if this will work. I've got the one knob hooked into the three pins on the MIDI brain. We're going to power it on by plugging in the USB cable. Now, it's a generic device, so you don't need any special drivers to get this going. Now I'll open up the UMC config software. This is one thing I really love about this board. You wire it up and it'll program itself to work the way you want. The software is PC only, but you only need to program it once to get your controller up and running. I choose a few settings in here, click some buttons, and now the UMC should do exactly what I want. And here's the moment of truth. Let's open up Ableton Live. I'm going to go into the settings to make sure Live is listening to the UMC. Now I'm going to go into Live's MIDI map mode. I'll click a random knob on the screen and turn this real knob. Now we exit MIDI map mode and the real knob turns the virtual knob. So we just learned how to get one knob to talk MIDI. But this controller has 24 knobs and 8 switches. We've got to figure out how to take what we just learned and apply it to multiple controls at once. Let's go back to this diagram. These pins, they're supposed to let you connect 8 components. But why are there just 10 pins and not 24? That's because we cheated a bit in step 2. Two of these 10 pins are meant to be shared between all 8 components. Here's a simple example. The green bits are unique to each component, but the red and black bits, they need to be shared. There's two ways to do this. You split the red and black wires in two, or you could hop the red and black wires from connector to connector. That's easy enough with two knobs, but it gets more complicated as you increase their number. Now this is doable. People create wiring looms like this all the time. It's just not too much fun. So what to do? We use another piece of equipment to do the dirty work. This is called the EXP8SC. The guys who make the UMC make this too. It connects to the 10 pins and automatically turns them into 8 sets of 3 pins. Plus, it gives you these handy terminal blocks, making wiring even easier. So this turns this into this. And now we can just do the same work we did back in step 2. One end of the cable goes into these blocks. The bare wire is tightened into place with a tiny screw. The other end is looped around each knob connector. Solder is applied and heat shrink tubing covers the unit. This is a reliable way to make the connection, but you might be able to get away with just using electrical tape if you don't want to deal with soldering. Okay, we're almost done. We have this, and we need to turn it into a usable controller. What's left is to work with that piece of plywood so it can contain everything we have here. Now we're at the point where the guy at your hardware store or maybe your dad can help you finish this off. I'm going to skip the rest of the narration and I'm going to ask you to visit the website so you can look at the various hardware, the measurements, and the drill bits I used to finish off this controller. And that's about it. We're pretty much done. I'm going to leave you with three last words of wisdom. One is that you really can do this. It's not rocket science. Just use the website to look at the various parts that went into this. Two is that this controller doesn't have to be a parametric equalizer. It can be any layout that you wish. Three is that this controller doesn't have to control music production software. MIDI controllers are used for DJing, for VJing, even for video editing in apps like Final Cut Pro. And that's about it. Thank you very much, and let me know what you'd like to see next.